Hi guys, this car lost its brakes and got involved in an accident. The damage is limited to this area. This video is about how I diagnose the cause and why you should always remember to change your brake fluid. Now let's get this. The two main causes of brake failure from spongy brakes are brake fluid leaks and wear or failure of the brake master cylinder. I start by checking the level of the brake fluid in the reservoir of the brake master cylinder. Fluid level checked out okay and the brake light wasn't on either. I then went ahead to check for leaks at all the four tires as well as at the master cylinder. No leaks. I proceeded to test the brake master cylinder by stepping firmly on the brake pedal to see if the pedal height would hold. If the pedal continues to sink to the floor or progressively feels softer as your foot rests on the pedal, then you know you have one master cylinder. This wasn't the case. Pedal height held steady and that ruled out a one master cylinder. I then took note of the fact that this car had never had its brake fluid flushed since it was got used 10 years ago. Brake fluid absorbs moisture over time and water is something you don't want in your brake system. When you push on the brake pedal, hydraulic pressure is exerted on the brake fluid, and because fluids are generally not compressible, it transfers the pressure to the pistons in the brake calipers, thereby depressing the brake pads. However, water in the brake fluid under the intense heat of the brake system, the moisture vaporizes, air is pretty much compressible, the vapor then compresses and the pedal becomes spongy or falls to the floor, and this was exactly what happened in this case. This kind of brake failure may be intermittent since braking tends to recover when the system cools down. Most manufacturers recommend changing your brake fluid every 3 years. Be sure to check out what's recommended in your owner's manual. I then went ahead to flush the brakes using DOT3 fluid as recommended on the cover of the brake fluid reservoir. I used this simple one-man bleeder since I work alone, made from a water bottle and some see-through tubing. Starting at the rear passenger tire, which features drum brakes, the tubing goes over the bleeder valve nipple. I zip tie to make sure that it doesn't come off, crack open the bleeder screw and then pump away at the brake pedal. Just check out the dirty fluid coming out. Yuck. Since this is the farthest away from the brake master cylinder, it took about 50 pumps of the brake. Fluid goes clear and that's done. I then proceeded to do the same at the rear driver side, front passenger, and lastly the front driver wheel. This is the sequence recommended for most cars. The other thing I should mention is that also throughout the bleeding process, you want to ensure that the fluid in the brake master cylinder reservoir doesn't go below the minimum mark. I basically topped off after every 25 stumps on the brake pedal. I decided to test the brake fluid just to see what I would find, and sure enough, it had over 4% of water content. And there you go. When was the last time you changed your brake fluid? Don't wait until you experience brake failure. Hope this was helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.